Hi, in this video I'm gonna share with you my experience of making headless gaming server with Steam Remote Play. Take this video as a scientific experiment. I'll share with you my observations and thoughts, but it's up to you to draw conclusions. The concept for this video evolved over time. First, I thought I'll make a video about remote gaming computer for price of Xbox One, as it has the same feature. Then I wanted to rant about how stupid this idea is and the struggle to make it work. But after some testing, it worked better than I expected, so I decided to make this video unbiased for you to decide. As a host system, I'll be using Dell OptiPlex 720 with specification listed on the screen. I picked it up some time ago for quite cheap and used it for virtualizing Windows and running Windows exclusive software. And for experiments and fun, choose the codename FunStation. I added SSD and additional RAM stick and it was working great for that use. The GT1030 I picked up recently for this experiment. I know that this setup doesn't scream powerhouse, but it's not supposed to. While GT1030 is not powerful, it's a good choice as it must fit low profile case and Dell's OEM power supply. It also won't be bottlenecked by the CPU. This will help establish whether more powerful hardware is needed, or in other words, if it has an impact on performance. I plowed up my current configuration and started from beginning. Windows must run natively as my CPU does not support instructions for directly accessing I/O from the virtual machine. So I opted for dual boot setup. I voluntarily installed Trojan 11 Pro and Debian. I ran Debian as my main system and boot into Windows when needed. I made a simple script that allows me to boot to Windows one time without messing with grub configuration. The main point of this experiment is the gaming server being headless to test how this setup will behave. This means no monitor, keyboard or mouse is connected and everything is realized and managed via remote access protocols. There are three things plugged into the machine: power cable, Ethernet cable and dummy HDMI plug. The last one is added as without it, remote play defaults to some obscure resolution. Also, from my testing, some games might not detect monitor and therefore not launch or won't allow higher resolution than the remote play defaults to. I'm using Microsoft's RDP protocol to manage the machine. And if you ask why not use that to stream games, the answer is, it was never intended for that kind of use and the input lag would be horrendous, beside of course the rest of the things that can go wrong with this approach. Configuring remote play is damn easy. You basically need to install Steam on both host and client machine, and if I remember correctly, you are ready to go. Games must be installed manually on the host machine, but you can tweak remote play settings directly on the client. Thing worth mentioning is when you launch remote play for the first time, it'll ask you to allow client to control the host machine. This prompt cannot be accepted via any remote protocol. In my case, the message was being displayed, but I had to go to the basement, connect the keyboard and manually hit enter. Slight inconvenience, but I believe that the developers never intended remote play to be used this way, so from experience I can tell you it could have been much worse. My first take on remote play was miserable. I wanted to go easy with game requirements, so I downloaded Team Fortress 2, Flatout 2 and Mafia. And any of them did not want to run. After a long time of debugging, adding some random start parameters that nobody knows what they actually do, I managed to launch Team Fortress 2. For some reason, the game must run in windowed mode, because mouse was chopping otherwise, but with remote play, this does not matter. the game will appear running in full screen anyway. After playing with the settings, the game ran quite good. Not on a competitive level, as the slight input lag is still there, but for occasional gameplay, it was fine. In terms of the other two games, I could not make them run. Flat out would display some random error, with no solution to be found on the internet, and MAYHEM would just not launch, not giving any error. With this initial experience, I was going to scrap this idea, but I realized that my approach was wrong. These games are old. MAYHEM, for example, was released almost 21 years ago. I realized I cannot blame remote play if the game does not work, as there might be multiple factors for this behavior. However, this illustrates serious issue with headless setup. Beside constantly switching between remote play and RDP, which is irritating and introduces one inconvenience I will talk about later, identifying the issue why the game does not launch is a nightmare. For example, you launch the game throws an error that you see for the fraction of a second, and the remote play session closes. If you launch the game via RDP to investigate, due to the changes in displaying method, following behaviors might occur. Game might refuse to launch on virtual display. Settings might reset. Error might be different. Windows will detect you trying to do something cursed and the system will crash. What I mean from all of this, with this complex setup, it's hard or sometimes impossible to investigate the real issue of error. This cannot be blamed on remote play, as once again, issues might not be related at all, and developers assumed you work with a mouse and a keyboard. I'm talking about this as this might be a serious issue if you're keen on playing specific title. This time, I decided to download more games while still going easy with requirements, so the game had a chance to run. And to my surprise, almost all of them worked. The games I tried, as well as the results, are listed on the screen. I decided not to try fixing any game if it did not launch, but tweak the settings for smooth framerate. But this video is not about game performance, but remote play on a headless machine, so let's jump to gimmicks related to this setup. First of all, obvious things. Input lag is there, so it's easy to say that remote play is far from ideal for competitive gaming. But as I previously said, for occasional gameplay for games like TF2, it should be fine. I actually spent some time playing like this, and for my case, it was fine. There are two additional things worth mentioning, speaking of input lag. First, there are free streaming options available in remote play settings, which are fast, balanced, and beautiful. From my experience, changing this option from default balanced to fast makes a massive positive difference when it comes to input lag. Second, mouse can behave funky when performing large movement. It's not always the case, but sometimes you might end up pointing the camera at not intended stuff. It might be my specific case, but I think that needed mentioning. I am happy to say that I did not notice any performance drops being introduced by remote play. I compared the results with gameplay from similar setups and they are quite matching. And let's be honest, if I can't tell a difference playing on such a potato, if you have something more powerful, you won't notice it too. By management, I mean how remote play works in a headless setup. The biggest issue is the one I discussed earlier, which is pain investigating issues when the game does not launch. I had to switch multiple times between RDP and remote play as they cannot work simultaneously. When using RDP, Windows will lock your screen by default and remote play needs access to your desktop for streaming games. So, launching one makes second exit. There are workarounds to this, like IKVMs or using different protocols, but they might introduce different issues. There is also this weird bug where remote play will almost instantly kick me out of session while trying to type in password, unless I'm connected via RDP. Yes, that's right. I have to be connected via RDP so I can log in via remote play to be then kicked out of RDP. I don't even have explanation for that, but I can tell you it's annoying. To be honest, I have no idea why.
Why would you do that? Why would you do any of that?
I think that unless you belong to a niche, like people having servers with GPU in their home lab and daily driving glorified terminals, or you hate fun noises like me, I don't think this setup has a valid use case. Wired connection will always be better, and there are ways to achieve this if you must export the computer out of your room. But on the other hand, it is something special about playing Windows games on a MacBook in complete silence while the PC is screaming in the basement and basically hosting GeForce Now yourself. I don't have substantive summary for you this time. I tried to include all the useful information I gathered by this experiment while being possibly unbiased. It's up to you how you interpret it. This is the end of this video. Leave a like if you enjoyed it or dislike if you didn't, and subscribe for more computer, course solutions and technology related content. Thanks for watching.